YouTube, welcome to Cafe Inoma and welcome to our reaction to Joe South. We are going to react to the song Walk a Mile in My Shoes. This is our first time single take honest reaction to this song, requested by our patron Roger. Let's get started, Salvio.
If I could be you, and you could be me, for just 1 hour. If we could find a way to get inside each other's mind. If you could see you through my eyes, instead of your ego, I believe you'd be surprised to see that you've been blind. Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Hey, before you abuse, criticize and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes. Now your whole world you see around you is just a reflection. And the law of karma says you're gonna reap just what you sow. Yeah. So unless you live the life of total perfection, you better be careful of every stone that you should throw. Yeah. And yet we spend the day throwing stones at one another, 'cause I don't think or wear my hair the same way you do. Well, I may be common people, but I'm your brother. And when you strike out and try to hurt me, it's a hurting you. Lord have mercy. Walk a mile. Walk a mile in my shoes. Hey, before you abuse, criticize and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes. There are people on reservations and out in the ghettos, and brother there, but for the grace of God, go you and that. And if I only had the wings of a little angel, well, don't you know I'd fly to the top of a mountain and then I'd cry. Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Hey, before you abuse, criticize and accuse, better walk a mile.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful lines, very strong lines and beautifully sung. Well played to the guitar, the vocals, everything was good. Well done by this artist. Strong lines, strong lines. These are some of the things we often say to our close friends, our best friend, our partner, our soulmate, even a sibling. We'll say, walk a mile in our shoes. You know, I mean, see things from our point of view. Then you'll realize how things are for us or how wrong you are in judging us, in analyzing us in a particular way. So it's words that will connect with scores of people worldwide. It seems to be a pretty old song by the sounds of it, the looks of it. It seems old, but the words are quite relevant in today's world. In fact, in today's world, thanks to social networking sites and apps, the words have become so much more powerful. Even one word, one emoji used incorrectly can cause havoc, can create havoc in a human being's life. And not just for one day, it might be for a long, long time. One emoji, one word used incorrectly, out of context, or something that doesn't go down too well with the receiver. Oh, it can create havoc, it can cause chaos, it can have horrific results. And that is seen specifically in the country which uses it the most on a daily basis. What is happening to them? Relationship-wise, family-wise, families are torn apart. There's no meaningful relationships in that nation. There's no meaningful communication in that nation. And the amusing part of it all is that those are the people who have created these apps. They all come from that one country. So as amusing as it is, I enjoyed listening to this song. It's a great request. I enjoyed it. A lyric video would have been wonderful for songs like this, but we couldn't find one on YouTube. So sad, so sad. YouTube has almost everything under the sun, but not a lyric video for a song like this.
What is commendable is the voice and the way he sang, Joe South, that everything was quite clear for me. There was no accent problem for me to understand it on the first listen. And I like that about songs that I hear for the first time. If I'm able to connect with the artist on all of the levels that I, you know, seek for, it's a win-win for me and it's a great song for me. I like the lyrics of the song. I like the simplicity in the way it was written. Very simple, very basic, but at the same time hard-hitting and, you know, to the point. The way it was sung was very cute, I would say. Sweetly, cutely, the way it was sung, and no complications in understanding what was being sung. It was clear. It reasoned with me. It you know, connects with me on the first listen itself. I know a lot of people seek for some kind of approval from others, or they always think that they need to make people understand why they are doing whatever they are doing, because they feel they are badly misunderstood by everyone around. Only when you go further in the same lane, you will realize it didn't even matter what others thought of you, what you may have been thinking about them and their opinions on you. None of that really matters. It's just time and how much time you take to get to that point. That when others' opinions, as long as your own opinion about yourself and you can, you know, face yourself in the mirror or, you know, always think that you're not doing something wrong, that's all matters. And what others think, whether they want to walk in your shoes, in their shoes, whoever's shoes, it does not really hold any importance in the life. Yeah. So where I know that this phase is there in life where, you know, you feel frustrated, you feel completely, you know, controlled by others' opinions about you, and you really feel the eagerness or the desire, the burning desire to make them believe or feel how you are, you know, thinking about it or what you're doing, it's the right thing and whatever. But beyond a point, it does not really matter. And when that day comes, you are truly liberated. You feel free. You feel as if you've never felt this kind of freedom ever before. So I hope everyone, at least before dying, they get to this point in their life when others' opinions or what others thought of this decision, that decision, the way I lived, what I did, when that does not matter. People, log kya kahenge, what people say does not matter. That day you truly live your life and you're free. You're literally free. You're wearing your clothes, but you feel so light and fluffy. That is the day people should actually experience. It just is amazing feeling. But I love the way this song was sung. Thank you, Roger, for you know, requesting this song. Otherwise, we would never have heard Joe South singing this song.